In this video, I'm going to go over the bond valuation problem that I assigned last week. And in this particular evaluation problem, you were given a bond has a coupon of 5%, matures in 7 years, and it has a current yield to maturity of 3.5%. Now, one thing to be mindful of is that if the yield to maturity is less than the coupon, your final answer better be greater than par or greater than $1,000, and vice versa. If the yield to maturity is greater than the coupon rate, then your final answer better be less than $1,000, less than par, or what we consider to be a discount bond. For this particular situation, for this particular problem, the yield to maturity, of course, is less than the coupon, so it's going to be selling for more than $1,000. It'll be selling as a premium bond. So just always keep that in mind, the relationship between the yield to maturity and the coupon of a bond. So in this particular case, as I said, 5% coupon, matures in 7 years with a yield to maturity of 3.5%. We know that when the bond matures that we're going to get back $1,000. So with that in mind, let's go ahead and set it up by way of the analyst. So from that standpoint, I just like to make sure everything is cleared out. So I want a clean worksheet, so I go second, clear TVM, right? Second future value. So when I hit that second key, I'm going to the clear TVM. Second of all, I want to know my compounding period is semi-annually, so I got to check that out. Second payment per year, well, it's already two. If it wasn't two, of course, I would go two and enter. So now the analyst knows that my compounding period is set up for semi-annual compounding. So let me just go second quick to get a nice clean cell. So now I can put in my information in the third row, because this is really my time value of money, and my time value of money is my present value, future value. And since I'm looking for the price of the bond, in terms of its present value, I'll go ahead and put values in for these, you might say, on known random variables. So for the first thing is, okay, I know that when the bond matures, I'm going to get back $1,000. So that will be my future value. I know that 7 years, but how many periods are we talking about? Well, we're talking about 14 periods in which I'm going to receive the interest. Yield to maturity is 3.5, so that's going to be my interest per year. I know the bond has a coupon of 5%, so that's $50 a year. However, the company is going to send me a check every 6 months for 25, so that's going into my payment. To find my price, compute present value, and the price of that bond is selling at $1,092.42. So when we think of determining the value of a bond, it is really the present value based upon a future value amount or a lump sum in the future to be received, and that's the maturity value of $1,000. And then in the interim, it's really determining the present value of an annuity amount, and that annuity amount is, of course, receiving $25 in interest every 6 months. So we have the present value of an annuity plus the present value of a lump sum, add them together, and we come up with $1,092.42. So that is your answer.